Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website, that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for January the 11th of 2020, well, it is titled NGC 602 and Beyond. So what do we see here? Well, this is a part of the Small Magellanic Cloud, and this is a star-forming region, and the young cluster at the center is known as NGC 602. And we can see a lot of blue stars there, and a lot of stars overall that have formed within this cluster, and around it we see the remnants of that formation. So when stars form, they form from a great cloud of gas and dust, and the material that does not form stars is left over and is pushed away. So you can see how the stars are kind of clearing out the interior of this area, pushing the gas and dust away. And you can also see little tendrils pointing in towards the star cluster at the center there. And those are the denser areas, possibly where stars are still trying to form. And it's a race as to whether those stars can form before the stars that have already formed eat away at that material and push it back from being able to form further stars. So will the stars eat away at that material, or will the new stars continue to form? So over time, this will eventually be completely cleared out, and you will no longer see any gas or dust. So the remnants of gas and dust are signs of very young stars having formed, and in this case, only about a 5 million year old star cluster, meaning that most of the hot stars are still there. Only the very hottest would have gone through their lives after 5 million years. Now, these are not the only things that we see within this cluster. We see the stars and the dust and gas left behind, but we can also see a lot of other objects in here. If you look around, you see a number of stars with the distinct diffraction pattern showing there, little cross pattern shown through there, and we can see other objects that do not show that, and most of those are galaxies. So we can see a lot of distant galaxies here, many millions of light years beyond, and in fact, one prominent spiral galaxy off towards the lower left-hand side we can see there. So there is a prominent spiral galaxy that we can note here, but if you look around the image, you can see a lot of other galaxies as well. Now, if we think about that, galaxies scattered all over the universe, that means there are also galaxies and more distant objects that are hidden behind other objects that could be hidden directly behind some of the bright dust and gas in front. So there are certainly objects within the universe that we still cannot see because they're being blocked out by other objects in front of them. Now, one of the things that's done here is we look at this with actually three different wavelengths, because different wavelengths do allow us to penetrate through different types of material. And in here, we're looking at X-rays and infrared radiation, as well as visible light. So we can see it in a couple different ways and allows us to see a little bit more than we would otherwise be able to. So that was our picture of the day for January the 11th of 2020. It was titled NGC 602 and Beyond. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Blue Corona. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.